Good evening, everyone. Can you hear me? Oh, James Fan. Oh, Carol, your first time, mate. Well, that's your first name that I can see. Good evening to you. Anyone else? Oh, Sue, Patricia. Nice to see you. Good evening. Wait, see if there's any more? We're not just on our own. Oh, Carol's saying hi, everyone. Oh, Jane's on. Ron is watching. Father Taman. Oh, no. Oh, blimey. Hold on. Got to behave myself now. Maria. Yes, I've only just left Father Taman. Very quickly, we had a sort of leadership team at meeting on Zoom at 8. And then once we finished that, it was just Father Taman and myself and Irene, the two church wardens, had a bit of a discussion. So, quick half hour. Did a couple of things and then, good evening. Yes, London Pride. I know Father Taman, he said he was going to have a Budweiser. I don't know if he has, if he can comment on me. So, good evening. It's Friday night. Good evening. Good evening, Sharon. Good evening, Sue. A different Sue. Sue Webb. I've got Sue Marsh. Cam. Good evening, Rebecca. Good evening, Margaret. Yes, mother-in-law. Good evening. Let's get on then. Good evening. Yes, you know me. I better say, name's Dave Jenner, one of the church wardens at St George's Church in Freezy Water. Welcome to my sort of regular thing, Friday night, T4TN, Thoughts for the Night. Always at 10 o'clock, Father Taman, Father Vince does them. It's my turn tonight, so good evening. Couple of things I wanted to share with you before we sort of kick off. Father Taman says cheers, I think he's got a drink. Yes, do you remember going back, God, time flies, I'm talking about not this Christmas, the Christmas before, when I said, oh, our poinsettia is still blooming, how long was it going to last? We'd had it the previous November. So, yes, we've still got it. And I just want to show you an update, bring it into thing. Yes, well, it never turned red. It just, there you go, in the pot. You wouldn't believe we won this in the raffle at the St. Peter's and Paul's Christmas meal. Be it not last Christmas before. So it's well over 12, 13, 15 months old, probably. Yeah, it's very green. Never went red in the winter, which you thought it would. But yeah, water it. So I don't know if anyone else has got, but I thought I'd just show you. It's on the, normally on the, oh, there you go, I'm on live on my phone. It's normally on the windowsill in the kitchen. I'll go back to its proper place, but there you go. Just say it's still going. But no, the leaves didn't go red, but there you go. So still life in the old dog yet, as they say. I've got to tell you this. Yesterday, as you know, on a Thursday, some of you, if you've seen the Facebook messages, we have something called the Felix Project. They're based in Enfield, and they help the community, people not so well off with food, and. Oh, hold on. Jane has just adjusted my set. I probably found out after. She's just come into the kitchen. Yeah, that's where I am, the kitchen. So, yes, the Felix Project. Yeah, they help with food to the less fortunate in the Enfield area. I know there's the North London Food Bank, etc. and others. And sometimes it's a school, but obviously through the lockdown, the church have taken it over and we've started doing it again on Thursday evenings. People come to the church at about 6 o'clock for an hour. And there's normally a mixture of bread, fruit, fresh vegetables, and some tin stuff. And a few, how can I call it, odd items. Well, it happened to be yesterday. I was at the church yesterday morning. And I'll be honest with you, just putting the last few Christmas things away. Yes, it does happen, probably in your household, if you're taking all your fancy lights down. But you need to pack them, probably put them in the loft. And we got a few things in church, but they were delayed because it was the table that had the crib set on, which was obviously until the start of Epiphany. On the big stand that holds the Advent candles on. And a few other things like that, a few lights. And we had the box that holds the sticks that hold the wreaths on that people put on. Their wreaths on in the garden remembrance, so that is sort of cleared up now. I was there with a couple of others, and we were putting the things back in the locker. So all of a sudden, Ronnie was there, you know, the parish administrator, and she said, Dave, that's the phone. She said, I think Felix Project are on their way. Could you give us a hand? So I said, yeah, of course. So the van turned up. Nice young couple got out, and they sort of they come in those big plastic containers, they wheel it on a four-wheel trolley into the church, and then we just transfer it. We have half a dozen tables. You might have seen the picture on it on our Facebook page. And we line up the bread and everything up. And it was I was sorting it out with a couple of others. And there was a couple of boxes. They were taped up, but there wasn't much like writing on them. You have to open things up so we can display it for when the people come that evening. And open it up, and it had Ministry of Defence. What have we got here? And would you believe it? It was how they got it, I don't know. And I don't know if Ronnie's on tonight. I haven't been looking at the comments. If they all went. But basically, yeah, you've probably seen this backwards, but it's... the Ministry of Defence, basically, it's a list of their 24-hour operational ration packs. Yes, in Enfield, we had the ration packs. Well, I opened one up just to have a look, and inside was, I call it, you know, like you get the old little sachets of tomato sauce in the cafe or at McDonald's. Well, it was like milk for your tea and coffee, and a couple of other sauce and couple of things. And then there was like these tablets, and I realized they were like glucose tablets, like, you know, the old barley sugar, give you, you know, a bit of energy. There was even a little plastic knife and fork. There was a little packet of tissues, and some other, it was like dehydrated, like a soup, and a few other a hot drink, etc. But on this list, I'm glad these never turn up. I put them through. It said reusable poly bag. That's if you don't know, hypothermia. A few scouting people would do that. Instant coffee, yeah, that's fine. Tea bag, matches, that wouldn't be very well to give out. A wet wipe, yeah, tissues, water purification tablets times 6, and assorted chewing gums. I like that, assorted chewing gums. But yes, and it's got a list of all your menus for the day. But I don't know if Ronnie is on, how they went, or Norman, I know Norman, or Ron and Carol were there. So if you've got anything... Yes, good evening, Ronnie. How did the MOD stuff go? Did it go? Did people take it, or did we have to got rid of it ourselves? But no, it was very interesting. So it'd be interesting to see what we get next week. But it, wonder what I'll put here. Wonder what we can give out next week. But it was the good stuff: the fruit and the veg, the potatoes, the tins of soup, the cans of soup, rice and all that for people. Bread, which is what they want, which is great, and some drinks and stuff. So searching through for sort of things for tonight. I don't know if you know, I'm a bit of a dab-an now, finding out there's some, like, I don't know, there seems to be something for every day, doesn't there? And today, would you believe it, is called the Celebration of Life Day, which I suppose in these times is sort of very important. As I've put here, very apt in these unusual times we are all in. And I just wanted to go through, like next week, Jane, my wife, you know very well, she has a week's holiday, can't go anywhere, but she's had to book holiday through work. A lot of people, you do it yourselves. If you don't, you lose it. So great, she can have a bit of a rest. I've been told she wants tea in bed every day, but I have to wait and see, but I'll do my best. But like us all, I've said here, we can't go far. Normally, we go out if we have a week off, probably go up London to visit a place, you know, day at the coast if the weather was was nice, and even have a drink in a nice country pub. But unfortunately, like ourselves and you, unfortunately we can't do any of that. So I'll probably take her down the shed at the bottom of the garden, quick tour, come back, that'll kill half hour, but we will have walks, etc., and whatever. But there you go. So unfortunately we can't do things like we normally do. But no, we're staying at home. But as I said, it's the one of those celebrations. It's life day to day, which we all have to try and think of our own and family's lives, which is obviously very important. We can obviously look, we can look to the future, hopefully one day, when yes, we can meet up with our extended family. You know, like I've got a brother, Martin Hollow, can't meet up. Niece and nephews, their children, and so forth, and Jane's side as well. Jane's, you know, we can't meet up, and we're all in the same boat. But we can always, as I say, if it's celebration of life, we're lucky that we're all here, and we can look back on the past, but hopefully look to the future when we can all get together. So, you know, we've got to try and be positive and celebrate in our life in the best way. So I need to turn over because I have to write from to the back. So, and we can take some time to try and understand that the good far outweighs the bad in this life. I know we all have our problems, but sometimes we're trying to be positive, which is sometimes not easy at the moment. And I suppose with God's help, we can try and be positive. We're all down. Yes, myself, and I know many of you, and we all have our ups and downs, and we fluctuate. I had to unfortunately go to a very good scouting friend's funeral yesterday, which is not nice. And we've all been in those situations. And all I would say, Teresa, she had a great life, and that's all I'm going to say on that. And you've got to try and look on those positive times. We have a gratitude and appreciation from where you and me are right now, and what we have to look forward to in the future. So I will have a look at a few comments. What's that? Good evening, Debbie. Good evening, Carol. Jane, I'll bring you tea in bed every morning usually. Oh, I know, she's let the cat out of the bag there. You spoiling. Well, Carol, you know, come on. Carol Wright. Yes, she might even come to Guardian on Tuesday. Yeah, she did say that. She'll sort us all out. it'd be great to see you. Good evening, Bella. Good evening. I might have said Debbie, I do apologise. They scroll up a bit slowly. I know sometimes what you can see and what I can see is a little bit different. But good evening, Bella. Hopefully, I know you would have been there last night helping with the Felix project, and hope it went well. And much appreciated. So, yes, and I've lost my spot. That's got to go down there. Yeah, so when one day we can all meet up once again, as I said, with our families, friends, even our, you know, including our children, grandchildren, etc., we will all believe how lucky we are that we can all once meet up. That time will come one day. So a celebration of life, the life that we have, which we all, as I said just now, we all take for granted, and we've got to, you know, try and be positive in these very unusual and hard times, and it isn't easy. So we can remember the happy times we've had in the past. We can look back on that, and it's fantastic nowadays, isn't it? You used to look at the old family photographs. I mean, I've got loads. You probably have, black and white, faded. I mean, now on your phone and your iPads that I'm looking at you at, it's so instant now, which is what fantastic, because they're the memories that you have, and you can keep looking back on the good times in your life and your family's and friends' life, which is so important. Every life is precious, as I've put here, individual and a huge gift. So take a little extra time, well, we can't today, well, you can if you wish to, or tomorrow, to celebrate it, which will give you more time to try and celebrate with the family that you can see at the moment, even if it's ringing someone up, which is a good thing to do, to remind them that, you know, you're there and you're thinking of them, they're thinking of you, and that is, I think, is the most important thing. So I'll just have a sweet, and good evening to Leslie, and good evening, Maureen. Nice to see you. Good evening. I haven't given a clue on my song yet, which will be very shortly, but all I will say, Shine Me Age, it came out in 1978. So yeah, we're back to the 70s. I was 20 then, would you believe that? Yeah, don't answer that. And it was always one of those classics that followed on. You always, I call it the old disco. I mean, you don't call them discos now, do you? You used to go to here at the disco, used to go to the Tottenham Royal, even being the scout group, dinner and dance, people's parties, because a lot of friends being 20 would have been 21 or 18 in sometimes said people celebrated. So we'll have it shortly, but it's by a band who, the only clue I'll give is by an American band, who, great singers, who shortly after this changed their name. Same name, but they had a number at the end of it. Before that, it was The Something, then it became the name and a number. And I'll give you a major clue. The lead singer, well, is one of the best. That's all I'm going to say. So you might have worked that out. Oh, got to say this, good morning. So we've got Janice, you and I, Jean Benson's, is it youngest daughter? Sorry, Janice, if I got that wrong. I do apologise. But one of Jean's daughters, who lives in near Melbourne. So I think she normally says it's about 9 o'clock in the morning. So we had quite a bit of a storm earlier, a bit of a rain here. And I expect you've got lovely sunshine. Ron Betwith, how's he nice to Jackson 5? He's on the ball, Ron. Carol, did you nudge him? No? So, good evening. Good morning, Janice. So, I'm hoping it's nice in the morning, because I'm going out with another fellow church warden, Mark Dowsett, with his brother. We're going out for a cycle ride up to, not too far, along the River Lee. And I've got to meet him at 9 o'clock by the River Lee at Waltham Cross. So, please pray for me that it's dry at least. I know it's going to be a bit fresh. You're the middle daughter, Janice. I think Kerry's the youngest. Because diverting here. We saw some lovely pictures of Lynn, who celebrated her silver wedding this week. So congratulations to Lynn. So, Forgo, anyone's birthday today? I know it's Carol and Ron's daughter-in-law, Tora, Victoria. I know it's her birthday today. So happy birthday to her. If there is, put them up, and because I get your comments a bit later. So yes, so happy birthday to anyone. My nephew, it's his stepdaughter's birthday today. She's 13. Yeah, Carol's put to it. Yeah, it's her birthday. I won't ask the lady's age. I'm not that. I'll be careful there. So just before I finish, and got some nice prayers to say. And then we'll have the song, and we will obviously, remember today is our celebrate life day, nothing more important, especially our children, grandchildren, families and friends. It's so most important. Janice has said, oh, from Australia, beautiful sunshine today, but going to be extremely hot on Monday. 41 degrees. We're lucky if we get 4. Oh, good old Australia. But it is your summer, isn't it? It is your summer. Yeah, it is your summer because it's our winter. So I'm not surprised. Hopefully you don't get those horrible bushfires that you had last year. Fingers crossed. I'm going to shortly now say a couple of prayers. And then we'll have, as I say, I call it the traditional Lord's Prayer. So if you're able to, you bow your heads for prayer. And you'll know these two very well. God be in my head and in my understanding. God be in my eyes and in my looking. God be in my mouth and in my speaking. God be in my heart and in my thinking. God be at my end and at my departing. Teach us, good Lord, to serve you as you deserve, to give and not to count the cost, to fight and not to heed the wounds, to toil and not to seek for rest, to labour and to ask for no reward, save that of knowing that we do your will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace we will lie down and sleep, for you alone, Lord, make us dwell in safety. And the Lord bless us and watch over us, and the Lord make his face to shine upon us and be gracious to us. And the Lord look kindly upon us and give us peace. Amen. Now if we can say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Thank you. Thank you for your amens on the screen. Thank you, Kelly, Carol, Father Taman, Rebecca, Margaret, Maureen, etc. Thank you. And I will now, hopefully on my phone, if I haven't lost it, find the song. And I think Ron had it earlier on. He said Jackson 5. Yeah, because this song, they were the Jacksons, and then they became the Jackson 5. And it's one of those classic where you could do a little bit of the moon, the sun. Yeah, I will play it now and we can. It's a good this. Because, yes, they were the Jacksons in and they became the Jackson 5. And Chris Michael doing his. I remember this down the old church hall, disco nights. Tottenham Royal, the Lyceum in the Strand, Sunday nights. Here we go. There you go. Ironic, Elton's in Tottenham. I remember Elton's. Is it Caesar's Palace in Luton? Bailey's in Watford? Yeah. What was the one in the Cross? Oh, used to be above the car park. Oh, no, we used to go to a place in where? Near the station. No, Terry, I can't remember that either. Yes. Cheers. Right. There he is. Michael Jackson going for us. He's got his white shoes on. Right, let's just turn that down a bit. Yeah, so thank you for joining tonight. Thanks for your comments. And nice to see you, everyone. Much appreciated. Hopefully you can all have a good weekend as much as you can with your families at home. Keep safe, keep well, keep strong. And think of Lord on Sunday. And if you can join us for Mass at 10 o'clock online, that would be fantastic. Be nice to see you all. And there will be Father Tony taking Mass tomorrow at midday, which will also be online. So hopefully we can see most of you then. And all have a good night and a good weekend. God bless. And I will see you very soon. So Beckett's in where? Thank you, Jane. Thank you, Diane. Oh, Diane, thank you. Good evening, and I will just play a little bit more. Good job. just got the sunshine, yeah. I've got the dance. Good time. Right. Good night, everyone. God bless. See you soon.